10 building tricks for compounds. Number 1. Did you know that out of all the weapons in the whole game, the Python is the most efficient for turrets? Yes, it does more damage per second than any other weapon, including MT49 and AK. They are also very cheap to craft and use pistol bullets, which are slightly cheaper than rifle bullets. The second one is very useful if you're bored of grubs shooting your turrets with bows trying to get to your precious pythons. Your turrets obviously can't shoot through regular walls, but they can shoot through these. This one is useless because it will block some of the bullets and it's very easy to shoot through. However, this one does not block the bullets from the turret, but it can still be shot through with bows. How do we stop this? What's better than one chain link fence? That's right, two. If you have two fence gates in front of your turret, the arrows will be blocked by the second one every single time. You can implement this into your design in a few ways, like this. Don't you hate when you're building your compound and the walls just don't line up? Then number 3 is for you. By holding shift when placing the walls, it enables a free mode where the wall isn't locked onto nearby walls, so you can place it more precisely. The next few tricks are going to be very anti-grub for those of you that don't like when people jump into your compound and take all your belongings. Number 4. If you place a twig floor going out of your gatehouse and place your metal barricades on top of the twig like this, the barricades will stick out a lot over the side of the gatehouse, which will stop people from being able to jump up on the side like this. Make sure that the center point of the barricade is not on the twig though, because then it will break as well. For trick number 5, we're going to be placing electrical components on the top of walls or doorways on the outside of your compound. This will stop those filthy grubs from placing any twig floors on the side of your base for an easy way in. Most deployables work, as long as they can be placed on walls. Trick number 6. While building a gatehouse, you should always put window frames on the sides like this, and put embrasures as well. Then align the high wall with the center of the embrasure, for a very useful peek for door campers both outside your compound and inside. Although, they shouldn't be inside if you have followed all these tricks. The 7th one is a very obvious one. Just don't build near cliffs. If you're planning on making a compound, don't build your base on the side of any hills or cliffs. Not only will it be easier for people to jump in, but it will also be much harder to place your high wall straight. Choose a good location, ideally completely flat. Usually fields, shallow beaches and ice lakes are perfect. For trick number 8, you should always place the foundations of your gatehouse as low as you can, because then the barricades on top will align with the sharp part on the high wall. This will make it harder for people to jump in with ladders. Trick number 9. If you're placing large furnaces in your compound, you should always place them close to the high walls, because if you put them in the middle of your compound, they can work as cover from turrets and hiding spots during online raids. So when placing them, always put them as far back as you can. Now if you're one of those Rust players that just enjoy tormenting people for your own enjoyment, you've probably had one of these in your base at some point. Yes, the last trick is about SAM sites. The way these work is they will only shoot if the target is above them. So don't put them on top of a big tower. The best spot is low to the ground with not too much in the way.